Good morning. I welcome you all to the series of lectures on internal combustion engines. Today we are going to discuss about the difference between four-stroke engine and two-stroke engine. Difference between, that means four-stroke engine versus two-stroke engine. So this is the valve timing diagram for the four-stroke engine. This is the port timing diagram for the two-stroke engine. So the basic differences are, this is a four-stroke engine, it is a two-stroke engine. Cycle is completed in 4 strokes of the piston. So that means if it is 4 stroke engine or 2 stroke engine, doesn't matter. The basic cycle, this one. So if the suction means, this is suction, compression, expansion, exhaust. So that means cycle is completed in 4 strokes of the piston. Here in 2 stroke engine, of course, this suction, compression, and this is exhaust port. This is a transfer port. Right. So, of course, here also cycle is completed in four processes only, but the processes are accompanied, and cycle is completed in two strokes of the piston. That means one stroke means the movement, piston movement from top dead center to bottom or bottom to top. The length between, the distance between TDC to BDC is called stroke. If the piston is performing one stroke, means it is covering from TDC to BDC or BDC to TDC, that is called stroke. So here the processes are all suction, compression, expansion, exhaust, all four processes are completed in two stroke. That means processes are accompanied in the strokes. So cycle is completed in four strokes of the piston. Cycle is completed in two strokes of the piston. Cycle is completed in two revolution of the crankshaft. This is the crankshaft. Suction, compression, expansion, exhaust. So two revolutions of the crankshaft is nothing but one cycle. Cycle is completed in two revolutions of the crankshaft. Here cycle is completed in one revolution of the crankshaft. Here the cycle is completed, so that means TDC to BDC one stroke, BDC to TDC is one more stroke. So that means it is only one revolution from top to bottom. Piston moving from top to bottom is this one, and bottom to top is from here to here. That means one revolution is equal to one cycle. One revolution of the crankshaft is one cycle. So it has one power stroke for two revolutions of the crankshaft. So see, suction, compression, one revolution. Expansion, exhaust, second revolution. So only one power stroke, that is only one expansion takes place for two revolutions. So it has one power stroke for two revolutions of the crankshaft. Here it has one power stroke from one revolution of the crankshaft. So for every one revolution, one power stroke. So that means the power stroke is, the power is double here. More amount of power you will get, same point here. Power output is more, not more, it is double here. Power output is less, half of the power developed by the two stroke engine. So four stroke engine power output is very less, that equal to half of the power developed by the two stroke engine. And it contains valves. See, this engine contains valves. This is inlet valve, this is exhaust valve. Here ports, exhaust port, transfer port, and there will be one inlet port here. Okay, intake port, transfer port, and exhaust port. Here it contains ports operated by the piston itself. When the piston is moving up and down, they are operated. There is no separate mechanism. Here there is a separate mechanism. So for this, camshaft is needed to operate the valves. I didn't mention that point, but I have just taken only the main points. But there are many differences are there. So separate camshaft is needed for to operate the valves here. There is no camshaft because the ports are operated by the piston movement itself. Heavier flywheel is required because as it is for two revolution, one power stroke. That means torque fluctuations are very high, so you need to control them. So large flywheel is required, flywheel size is more. So one revolution, one power stroke, so torque fluctuation is less. So torque fluctuation is less means lighter flywheel is required, lighter flywheel is sufficient. Efficiency is high here, even work output is less, efficiency is high because efficiency is equal to work by heat supplied Q. Here heat supplied is less, very less, because work output is less, but heat supplied is very, very less. That's why efficiency is more here. But here efficiency is less, but power output is more, because efficiency is equal to W by Q, heat supplied. So because this Q is very high, of course work output is very high, but Q is very, very high. So the rate of increment in Q is more than rate of increment in work output. So the efficiency is reduced, because this value is very, very high than this one. So automatically efficiency is less. But comparatively, W is less here, W is more here. But Q is very high. Of course, both are increasing, but this increment is very dominant, so automatically efficiencies drop. Power output is more, efficiency is less. This efficiency is less because of the scavenging. If you know, during suction, during exhaust, this fresh air is also going along with the exhaust gases without participating in the combustion. So most of the fuel is wastage and pollution is also more here. So that's why we are eliminating this engine. Of course, most of the fuel is wastage, so Q is more. So that's why efficiency is less here. Thank you very much.